Again, yeah, I wrote an article a couple of months ago saying that personal finance was probably one of the killer apps of Web 2.0.
Yep.
Because again, you leverage there's a real online community, so you need to leverage the community and to engage your members to share tips, to share the same goals. So that's very important in terms of word of mouth as well.
Right.
So you need to do that. I think that successful companies will be the companies which will manage to engage those people. So I'm quite interested in terms of your approach on that aspect.
You want to make sure that it's all personal finances are personal and they're private, and you don't want to expose that information to anyone.
Nope.
So any community, any comparison that you do needs to respect that person's privacy and make sure that none of the data gets out there. Which is why at Mint, you're anonymous. We never ask you for your name or your address or your social security number, just an email and a zip code, which aids in categorization. So the kind of community that we might have in the future would be, what does the average person in New York spend on gas each month?
Mm-hmm.
How much do they spend on restaurants? How much does a family like mine spend? More to aid in budgeting and sort of a comparison competition model. And we'd rather see professional content rather than tips from the community. Sometimes they're good, but you need to make sure they're filtered. Otherwise, you get a lot of garbage.
Of course, yeah. So you're more into, as you said, the professional advice from experts than just the user-generated content from the people like you and me. We don't have an expertise in managing your money.
Well, I think people like you and me might give pretty good advice. But the average user, some of them are great. But you want to make sure that you get your financial advice from a trusted source. You want to make sure that it's well quantified,
mm-hmm.
Which is what Mint's patent-pending algorithms do. Your friends don't always give the best financial advice.
No.
I'll just leave it at that.
Okay. Now, my point being, when you engage a community, usually
you
want people to spend time on your platform. So you want to kind of recognize that time, so you want maybe to give them more visibility, but in that case, anyway, you're anonymous, so that's not that. It's not like on a social network where you want to see if someone has posted a lot, so it's slightly different anyway, so the approach is...
I'll take a contrarian view on that, which is I don't think that... Mint does not measure its success in terms of page views or time spent on site.
Mm-hmm.
People want a quick and easy experience with personal finance. They don't want to spend hours managing their money. They want to get in and out quickly. They don't even necessarily need to log into Mint, because once you've got alerts for low balances or budget alerts or my paycheck got deposited, the information comes to you. You don't even have to log in. You don't have to log in to four different banks.
Mm-hmm.
You don't even have to necessarily log in to Mint, even though you see it all in one location, because the information, the relevant information, gets pushed out to you. So our success is not page views. It's not time on site. It's actual utility in getting control of your finances.
Yeah, easiness of you. Yeah, you're right, actually. In terms of families, do you have a feature which enables someone to set up accounts for his or her children, or, in terms of, again, urge people to do everything online in terms of personal finance, managing your money?
Yeah, one feature that's been requested by some families is the ability to almost have like an administrator view, where if you're a parent, you can see your college students' finances.
Indeed,
and keep track of them. Or as a family, have sort of multiple logins that go to the same place. So it's definitely something that we're investigating.
Working on, you're thinking about it.
Okay. Right.
Well, again, it doesn't make sense, and does it fit your strategy?
Exactly.
That's different. But okay, I know you're very busy. Your relationships with banks, so I guess anyway you can have business relationships with them, so they don't see you as a threat per se.
Right.
And second question would be, what if tomorrow banks are providing better and better, personal finance management tools? Could it be a threat to the contrary to you or to all the personal finance websites like Mint's? Well, how do you, again, envision that in the future, the relationship with banks?
Sure. So answer number one, our relationship with banks is, as a company, we only make money if we can save you money. So if you switch from that Bank of America or that Wachovia or whatever account that's not paying you enough interest, that's charging you too many bank fees, to a higher interest rate account, sometimes we get paid a referral fee or a credit card that gives you a better interest rate or more rewards, or even finds, Mint finds a lower price on your monthly bills, phone, cable, internet. So if banks do more personal finance online, you need to make sure that, one, you can get all of your accounts together in one place, so that it's a nice, easy-to-use interface. And two, you want to make sure that they're objective, because one of the reasons why Mint does not deeply partner with banks, only on the referral basis, but why it's not integrated into a bank right now, is somebody like Bank of America says, yeah, we'd love to use Mint, but you can only show Bank of America products on your Ways to Save page. So you can't ever tell people to switch from a Bank of America account to a Capital One or an ING or an HSBC, and all of a sudden you lose the unbiased, objective consumer advocacy standpoint, which Mint.com is strives to have.
Indeed, yeah. Good response. Okay, good answer. Okay, well, thanks a lot for your time, Aaron. It's been a huge pleasure, and I wish you the best. And hopefully I'll see you again on visiblebanking.com.
Yeah, thanks to all of those who spend their time on Visible Banking.
Thanks. Bye-bye.
Okay, bye.